this just se- like that's the thing. If you're not peak meta banging, you're just losing the game. Especially into like all these old school Pokemon that have come back. Like if you play honest, you lose. That's been the theme since like for the entire generation, but it's as true now. So how's my Lodic going to mess me up here? I get my Amnesia, I get my Curse, and then we win the game. Ooh, I like it. See, like, Milotic is meant to just be, like, the most annoying Pokemon, and you gotta hax it a bit. Infatuation, devastatingly powerful. But we're also very special-oriented. So it just comes down to how many 50-50s. Alright, we get one Amnesia, we're just, like, set. And now that means we have to be using Curse. So we're stacked into his, like, one physical threat. I think Zangoose can get nasty if it outspeeds and gets the setup it wants. Burn is significant. Yeah. That is how it goes. I'm a bigger fan of, like, Rest, Sleep, Talk, Milotic, but then you have, like, no kill pressure. Yeah, we do have Rest for the burn, which is fine. I'm trying to wonder when things get bad enough that we Rest. I want to get one more Curse. And I think, like, if we get burned, then we just start spamming Rust. He has to switch. Like, I think he's just going to think he grinds it down. But if I'm set up, of course I have a sustain. But now he, like, he wants the crit, he wants to burn the matter, and he wants me to get locked out for 3 turns. Anything's possible with how unlucky I am. The attract lead is risky, though. For that female tech. Like, that was actually a consideration back in, like, Generation 6, where it's like, yeah, female tech. No, like, other thing that it does, though. It's like, I guess if you're not a setup tank, this Milotic doesn't get KO'd and then has a chance of just chomping you down. We'll get that. And now we're just too fat. Now we can full Rest out and we're okay. I want one more Calm Mind. Not Calm Mind, Curse. Also, it's not Rest Milotic for the Marvel scale. It's over. Game's over. Isn't it great that Scald comes back and it's immediately annoying? That's fine, I'm okay to be immobilized every once in a while. He earned it on the strat. Track doesn't cut genderless, which is also why Cryogonal is the worst track user. That would be the cheat code if, like, you could attract anything genderless, but no. It's over. Draining Kiss Sustain, like, if you're not into a special tank boosting special defense, might be alright. I think you just want, like, Leftovers, Rest, Sleep, Talk, Scald, not Attract. Just gotta recover. Well, I mean, like, as much as I hate these stally ones, because, like, this is just, we're right back in Generation 6. Oh, yeah, it does get Recover. So, like, the Rest, Sleep, Talk is weird because you're eating up that extra slot where you can recover. I also might need to max out Curse. Because we have to use it 5 times. I don't like the immobilization. I don't know how much damage. Like, we're gonna go Terra Crunch here, and then Marvel Scale is actually just doing a third. Also, we could get burned and then, like, we lose a damage play. So I want this curse. We're at 5. 5 is, like, efficiency numbers versus 6. The thing is, this guy doesn't have anything. Again, it's a crit and 3 immobilizations in a row. Man, remember when Burn used to do an 8th? That was rough. So, I mean, like, tank play has always been weird. Like, Scald more common, much more powerful on the 8th. Will-O-Wisp strats also much more powerful on the 8th. But tanks just survive. And now, like, anti-tank meta. It's also weird. I don't know what the timer stall is here. It's free. Why are you timer stalling? Yo, he's going PP out. See, I want that 5th curse just so we're healthy, but things are annoying. Doesn't mean, like, if you can shut down the right Pokemon for long enough, and if you have a nasty Terra, this does have good odds on the Infatuation just winning you a game. Ooh, big play. Terra Fairy. Get that Drain Kiss damage. Terra Water. Question marks. Wait, what? He just wants 30% more damage now. This is his crit gamble. That was his crit gamble. Alright. There. This is... bringing back Snorlax and losing to a crit is as classic as possible. Uh-oh. Infatuation. It's getting it. Okay. That might do it. I guess we got greedy on the curses. I should have threaded in an amnesia, but it didn't seem like enough damage. Did we take less than 33? After the Terra, I lost these numbers. One health. 5. Snorlax, please, don't be horny. Ah! Classic. Was that 4 in a row? I think that was 4 in a row. Alright, now they have to do it again! Sinistra, no gender, though. Wow, all these weird genderless and paradox Pokemon and Ultra Beasts kind of nerfing the strat. Now he has a plan. I mean, I would say they coin flip the game into my Snorlax, because, like, game's over otherwise. Why do I have to fear this Goodra? What's the Goodra gonna do? Actually, the Goodra completely walls me out because this is one of those, like, things on the Terra Blast. Terra Ice might be the play. We're gonna have to, like, see more reason to want it. I mean, it's got Sapsa for sure, but the problem is, like, yeah, the Terra Bug does no damage. I don't know what its sustain option is left over, so we just need a plus 6. Yo, this guy's just a haxy boy. Dragon Breath for Paralysis? So speaking of stealing wins. Oh, no. This was is like, we lost to so much hacks, how do we even feel about it? Bro, Terra Ice ends this game, and that's so sad. Last call mine. Like, we have to matcha. Even though, like, of course it saps it. But, like, we need a burn on this thing. And the sustain is also something. We can strength sap it back up a bit. Like, I think we get one, unless this is like that weird power creep where it doesn't even have like wasted attack stats. No, it's doing good draw with 100 attack. This is like almost a full heal. Bro, is it Gooey? Is it Shell Armor? The way he, like, went into it has to be sap. Hey, you have to have a sap zipper to back up your Milotic. Dang. This is going to do so no damage. Also, I'm seeming of Assault Vest. Does sap zipper work on stats? Oh, wait. If the strength sap gets through, then it's not sap zipper? Yeah, right. Or do we learn something? No! It did not register that strength sap is that. No damage. We need the burn. There it is. Oh, wow. Okay. He's allowed to get a 116. I'm allowed this. We actually have to, like, do stuff here. That's getting very painful. Could have gotten Terra Bug earlier for the Acid Spray, but at any point it can also just start flamethrowing us. It hasn't yet, though. Yeah, the health source is going down. Oh, jeez, crit. No, that's just raw damage, because, like, we're already negative, so I guess crit doesn't matter. Dang. I'm pretty sure there's a guide or a video that has my Cresselia. If not several videos and streams. So what we did want is we wanted to save our Terra. I got greedy there and I got stupid on that, I guess. Because yeah, we want a Terra here to get the most fairy damage. He kind of doesn't have much else though. And we still have a Citrus Berry. Leftovers over Assault Vest, which is just negating burn. Damn, that Terra Fairy would have been way better. I'm also mad. Oh wait, actually, we just have to worry about time now, because like the Snorlax got stalled for so long. I'm thinking three Calm Minds, and then we just start going. Raining Kiss. Can't Terra. See, I think my biggest weakness as a Pokemon player is that, like, once we lose to the RNG, I just don't play optimal anymore, because I'm like, ah, the game's lost, what can you do? 1 in 16 plus game. Wow, it's still no damage. Yeah, the Terra Fairy, though, pushing that up. Oh, cool crit. Bro, that damage matters even more. Bro, if he survives the damage roll, you never see anyone this lucky. The irony of the acid spray at like minus five versus like a minus five crit acid spray versus minus six damage, I think is the same. But also, one of my strengths is I can completely misplay Int or get lazy and then still reverse sweep it on tank setup. And of course, he got the damage roll. This is one of the luckier players we've ever seen. Wow, but not proccing Citrus Berry is really good for me. Now he has timer. But he didn't stall it there, okay. Plus three Flutterman. Does that KO the Milotic, who's gonna have like max special defense? We need the Shadow Ball, like we need turn one Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball, Shadow Ball. Also, we need to not end our Terra Fairy, but like I said, like, it's already been such an unlucky game, you can't really say anything about it. I don't think anyone can look at this battle and be like, yeah, he deserved to win. Oh, now it's like hyper timer stalling. We win without timer as well, so like, this dude like doesn't deserve to win cubed. Timer stall, unbelievable hacks. Milotic's already down damage. Oh boy. Shadow Ball takes it from that range. It's gotta! Oh man, do we bring it back? Get out of here, animations! Taking too long. Like, did that just take so long that like the double timer doesn't give us enough time? I think we have a turn. Chimecho is the only one left. No Terra, so we just Shadow Ball and win. We don't even like Draining Kiss for health. Oof. Close one. That's a battle. That was a war. That was an entire war. Timer Staller is always the one with full shiny teams. Yeah. Bro, it's been all shiny teams. Like, everyone's just cheating as well. That's how you know I'm the best Pokemon battler. Because I'm beating all the hackers legit. And, like, if there was no cheating, I would be so unbelievably unstoppable.